We are going to see about linear induction motor and linear synchronous motor in this session. Right? We already actually in another video which I have posted earlier, we discussed about linear switched reluctance motor, linear SR. Here today we are going to, with this video lecture, we are going to see about linear induction motor and linear synchronous motor. As I explained in the previous video, which talks about linear SRM, the working principle of linear induction motor and linear synchronous motor are same as to that of the rotary machine. So principle wise, all the motors, whether it is linear SRM or induction motor or synchronous motor, principle wise all are working same. But the only difference is that the conventional motors give rotary motion, where the linear motors are giving linear motion. That is the only fundamental difference. So the operating principle or working principle and the basic theory behind the motors remains same. Only thing which is changing is the movement or motion of the machine, right? In conventional machine we have a rotary motion, and here we are, the machines are giving linear motion. So go on to the next slide. This is what I just told you about, right? Characteristically, linear induction motor have finite primary or secondary length which generate end effects. That means that is a basic difference, key difference between the rotary induction machine and the linear induction machine. If you read that, the conventional induction motor is arranged in an endless loop, but here the primary and secondary lengths are having end effects. So 2 points to be noted here is that in the machine we call it a stator and rotor, but here in the LIM we call them as primary and secondary. The stator is called as primary and the rotor is called as secondary, right? The second thing is that the linear motor has end effects and the rotary motor is arranged in endless loop. Can have a look at the diagrams. The conventional rotary machine, it's a cutaway diagram. You can say it's not a cutaway diagram, it's a just the machine which is being cut and rolled out for a linear machine. So the same diagram is being cut and rolled out in order to show how the linear induction motor looks like. If you cut the center of the polyphase induction motor and lay it on a flat surface, it forms a primary of the linear induction motor. Similarly, cut and lay down the rotor of the conventional induction motor will give secondary of the linear induction machine. So when you are, if you want to write something more about the constructional aspect, then you have to write down the general things which are available for the construction of induction motor to be here, right? This is a double-sided linear induction motor which we have already seen in LSRM also, right? Double-sided machines are having two primary and secondary. Primary is placed at both sides of the secondary. This slide briefly gives an overview of the operating principles of linear induction motor. So supply will be given to the primary winding, that is the stator. In a conventional machine, it is stator, to the primary winding of the machine, that will produce magnetic field. That magnetic flux will travel along the primary, and if you have a look at the second point, this linearly traveling magnetic field is equivalent to the rotating magnetic field in the stator of three phase induction machine. So the current it induced in the conductors of the rotor in the conventional machine, that is how the interaction happens between the stator and the rotor, and thus it produces a magnetic field, and that will induce, or it will induce a magnetic field that will tend the rotor to rotate in the machine, right? Here that is what happening in the between the primary and secondary, and that will let the secondary to move in a particular direction. So if you read the last point, electric current gets induced in the conductors of the secondary due to the relative motion between the traveling flux and the conductor. It's very that is what happens in the induction motor between the stator and rotor, right? So that will interact with the traveling flux and it will produce linear force or thrust. There we call it as a rotation, but here it is not the rotation, it produces linear force. That is the basic difference between the conventional induction motor and linear induction motor. We will have a look at the top speed CARA. Here it is the force to versus speed, or the thrust versus speed CARA is what we are going to see. That is in the other slide. So have a look at the velocity equation. Velocity equation is given as Vs is equal to 2 into T Fs, where T is the pole pitch. T is the pole pitch and Fs is the supply frequency. So it gives the velocity of the stator actually, right? It is giving the velocity of the primary linear. That is why it is given as velocity of the linear traveling field, which is explained or given as 2TFS meter per second. This is the synchronous speed of the field, which is represented as NS is equal to 2FS. Actually, S is suffix here because it is the supply frequency 2FS by P, where P is the number of poles. And we know that the in induction motor, the rotating magnetic field will always, rotating magnetic field will always try to catch up the stator magnetic field, right? But it doesn't happen. That is why there is a difference between difference in speed between the synchronous speed and the actual speed of the motor, and that is what we call as slip. In the linear motor also, slip is there. As the working principle and other parameters remain same, characteristics of the linear induction motor is exactly similar to that of the conventional induction motor. Here, this machine also has slip. So, slip is denoted by S. That is why I very specifically mentioned here, NS is 2F suffix S, it is not S, 2F suffix SP. FS is supply frequency. So, hence, for a slip of S, the speed of the linear induction motor will be, this is the speed of the force, right? Speed of the rotating magnetic, rotor magnetic field, that is represented by 1 minus S into Vs. Some of the key applications of the linear induction motor. One of the most popular application is automatic sliding doors in electric trains, and several other applications are, for linear induction motor is utilized for several other applications as listed here. Next we will move on to the linear synchronous motor. Again, if you read it out, it gives the same overview. A linear synchronous motor is basically a rotary synchronous motor unrolled flat. So the operation, construction, everything remains the same, but again it is going to be appear flat for the linear motion. And the linear synchronous motor can be of slotted, slotless iron core, ironless core and slotless. So this figures and the points which are mentioned here will give you an overview of what is iron core, ironless core and slotless. Just have a read from the PPT. We'll go to the next slide. It gives the construction features of the synchronous machine, where the stator is the electromagnet and rotor has permanent magnets. Here the primary, so in our case, in linear synchronous motor, primary has electromagnet and secondary has permanent magnet. If you read the first point, primary is having polyphase electromagnet linearly arranged such that a traveling magnetic field is produced in the air gap. It is usually stationary and attached along a track. So one of the key application of this, other than that of the door, the linear motors, as we discussed in the as I just explained in the linear SRM, levitators are also working with the same technology. So it is usually stationary and attached along the track or along a track. Whatever is the application, it has a track for the primary, and the secondary will travel along, right? So in the track, the electromagnets are placed placed in a regular distance, and they are powered by electric supply. Secondary part is generally an array of permanent magnets arranged in an alternating way and usually attached to the load. So the one which is supposed to move, that is what we call as load here, right? The door is, the sliding door in the electric train, or the trains are attached with the moving part or secondary. The secondary part of the synchronous machine or induction machine is attached to it. So that load is load contains the permanent magnets. Working principle is same as that of the rotary synchronous machine. So whenever power supply is given, it produces the magnetic field, and then that will let the permanent magnets attached to secondary to repel, so that it will make a linear motion. This is showing the double-sided SRM. Can see that here the primary, it is electromagnet coil, and the secondary is having permanent magnets. These are the other two types: slotless single-sided with the traveling magnetic field. This is nothing but the permanent magnets, and slotless single-sided air core. This is one of the key things you should know from the 6th module. In the last year university exam also, this was one of the questions to derive the linear force equation of linear induction motor. You have to draw this graph actually. Thrust, stresses, speed graph need to be drawn. It is exactly similar to that of the rotary induction motor, and the force is derived from F is equal to air gap power divided by linear synchronous velocity, which we have already seen. You have to derive that equation. So these are the equation which you need to write when you are going to derive the linear force equation. Slip equation is given here. It is not V, it is VR. We have seen already VR is equal to 1 minus S into VS. Mechanical power developed is expressed as P mechanical is equal to PR into 1 minus S, rotor copper loss, then the efficiency equation. So these are the some common equations you need to know and which you have to explain, right? So with this, I am winding up the discussion about the linear induction motor and linear synchronous motor. As I explained, the constructional features and the characteristics of all the linear motors are exactly similar to that of the rotary machines, with some additional features. It vary between machine to machine. And we discuss about the linear induction motor and synchronous motor here. We discuss about the linear force equation, and also their operation has also been explained. Thank you.